Welcome to AHA, a human among humans. I have one of the very best humans I've ever met. You might have seen her before, Susan Allen, who frees our voice to sing and talk in a new way. And she is helping me. I love the process. It's challenging. My name is Michael Coram. This is AHA, a human among humans. And Susan's going to help me begin to speak and sing this song, poem, Got Rot, Unknot.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Michael. I really appreciate that. It's wonderful to be here today. And I might start with just a small introduction of what it means in the Alexander technique to understand how indirect means whereby actually helps in the habits that we have, that we form, that cause us sometimes stiffness or pain. And just
so I'm going to translate that to mean in an indirect way.
Yes.
We can get rid of our stiffness and pain.
Yes, exactly. That's very, very well put. Thank you. You're so inspiring. So it doesn't start by fixing anything. It doesn't start by actually doing anything.
Well, let me challenge that, because I'm learning from you.
Yeah.
For me, you're helping me get rid of tension in my voice and body, indirectly, as you say. Mm-hmm. So it is aiming to heal me of this unnecessary tension.
That is a goal. Yep. You're right. However, the way to that goal.
Every moment, that's the goal, yes.
Very, very indirect. And
maybe, I'm not so sure. give our audience an example of what you're calling an indirect way.
So
help me get rid of, I have a little now. I'm speaking more clearly today than I have for a very long time. There's still a little hoarseness in my voice, but it's coming from a much deeper place, much thanks to you. Now, one challenge, which I don't want to rush, is to get to this deeper place. As you can hear, I'm speaking slowly, maybe somewhat robotically, like a robot, but it's way more me anyway, because it comes from my being, my whole body, and not just my throat. I'm not just a mind and a head. Guess what?
What just happened? What did you notice that just happened when you said, I'm not just my throat and not just my mind?
Consciously spoke from my throat and mind.
Yes. And what else happened to your body?
I guess it was left behind. It wasn't very happy about that.
There was something very important, and I noticed it, and I don't know if the audience noticed it, but when you went to speak about that you're not just a voice and not just a mind, you did something which was really interesting. And it actually was an automatic movement. And I bet
That like that?
we could call it an automatic movement and habituation.
I
A
don't think so.
habitual.
I think I did it consciously.
Good. Okay, we're in the money right now.
Fortune, yes, we're making.
If you did it consciously, we're in the money.
Oh, yes, thanks to you, I did it consciously.
And when you speak from your quote lower place,
Or
where is that?
all of me, really, from the center of my body,
Ah.
from my belly, from my feet, even, from the
Wow.
soul, even maybe the energy coming from the floor through my soul, through my heart, through my guts and heart, throat, lips, and mind.
Yes. Yes, and
Susan,
I can hear that.
you're now going to sing all of me for our audience.
Am.
Well, it really means that I haven't given all of me, even to me, let alone to anyone else.
Very interesting.
Which is why the poem song for today is called exactly what you're teaching. Dot rot, unknot.
Nice. Would you like to just go ahead and just allow your whole body, your whole being to
Right, and I hope I don't lose it. Oh, I'm going to do it two ways. I am going to do it slowly, trying to honor what you're teaching me, and then maybe messing it up by trying to do it in a quicker rhythm.
when you do it in the quicker rhythm, I have something to suggest to you.
Good. Why don't I first do it slowly, then you can make the suggestion. Because
And
you're very.
remember, we're just experimenting.
No, this is going to be live at Lincoln Center.
Well, honestly, they just experiment too.
Yes. You
It's
know
true.
the old mantra, how do I get to Lincoln Center? You remember the answer?
Practice, practice, practice.
Yes. Okay. I like to do it actually three ways. Just to pay attention to letting my whole body, mind, spirit speak it. That'll be example number one.
All
I
right.
can still sound like a robot learning to be a human being, which is what this program is about.
Aha.
Yes, why else would someone call their program A Human Among Humans, except for the fact that that is such a challenge for them?
Exactly.
Not all of us
And
can be as human as you are, Susan.
I know I'm very, very human. Yes,
Yes.
it's taken me all of my 70 years to become very, very human. Believe me,
Well,
life has knocked me this way and that way and every which way.
oh, me
Yes.
too. That's probably why we're friends.
That's probably true.
Okay.
Now, you don't mind if I watch you, do you?
It might even add to my enjoyment. Got rot, I'm not. Rotting to the core. Rotten to the core. My infecting sores rot me to my core.
Yes.
Now, I used to sing this as comedy. I am going to try just to compare. But it was before I learned from you, however. Rotting, you see, I'm doing it wrong. I can't do it that way anymore.
What did you catch? What
I'm doing it from my head, my comedy head, supposedly.
What is happening when you do that?
I go in the, I do rotting, I lose my whole body, even my
and
throat.
And you're losing your voice.
Yes. A small price to pay for a laugh.
Huge price.
Yes. No, I put an ad in the Globe. If anyone finds my voice, great reward will be. You have helped find it. You should get the reward.
I should get the great reward. No way. Now, I have a suggestion. You said you wanted to be funny. You wanted it to be funny, and you felt like, to me, you felt like you had to be wrong, do something wrong in order to be funny.
Right, it was my old way.
I would point out that there's maybe a lovely challenge here, a tremendous challenge.
Yes.
With inflection.
Yes.
With consonants.
Yes.
With elongated vowels.
Wow. Do you want to try?
What about those kinds of things with in expression?
Rotting. Oops, it's very hard to get out of the old pattern. Rotting to the core.
I have a suggestion.
Yes.
Can you say it a little bit faster?
Rotting to the core. That's too slow still.
No. Absolutely faster. Rotting to the core.
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 Really?
Yes, rotting to the core.
Okay. Rot, rot, rot.
My infecting sores rot me through my core.
I still hear a deep, deep, deep sadness in that.
Good. It's hard to pay attention to the emotions when I'm focusing on the sounds.
Well, it's coming across.
Oh, good.
Well, you know, not everybody takes a poem like and expresses themselves within the poem as if they are rotting from the inside, and they are rotten from the inside.
Yeah. No, you've helped me feel the truth of my wow, look at my voice going now. It's a very sensitive. My voice often leaves me when I get emotional. Because I am afraid of the emotion, the real emotion. I'd rather talk about the emotion.
Rather, and that's probably why the 001 may have some kind of bearing on that, because if I were to say 001 rotten to the core,
I can hear the sadness in that too.
There's something that comes forth from the, and I can't tell you how it does it, but there is something that comes forth when you just are yourself. And you, when I say that, you just speak from your whole being. Just simply speak.
There's something we discovered, I think, on a previous show, maybe preparing, that the words call up emotions.
They do.
And you might like this. Instead of trying to get in touch with my rotten core, which is in some ways sometimes a little work, if I just allow the words when I'm speaking them honestly, whatever that means, those words can bring up many feelings.
Yes.
Without me trying to manufacture the feelings or remember them.
And the truth is that you can't make anybody feel this poem. They have to be able to feel it themselves. And so the only thing that you can do is to be a clear channel.
Maybe. I think that's certainly true. I think I'm learning with you. If I say a word honestly, with my whole body, mind, and spirit, and let the words bring up feelings and thoughts, that's a powerful way of singing or talking. People can really feel that.
And you know, Michael, that happens in singing as well. It happens in singing. So it's so different when the whole body speaks. So would you try it?
Sure. So I'm going to sing it again. Is that it?
Yes, that would be great. How about the first two or three phrases? Let's see how it goes.
When you, my love, treated like a whore, festering with sores, will rot many cores. I did that wrong. I thought, I'm learning from you, if I could be so present to the word festering and not be thinking of the end of the sentence, which is the end of the phrase, which is sores. I think that's what you're telling me.
Yes, there's something magical about when the body leaves the words alone. In other words, there's something magical that happens when the nervous system speaks within the whole body, spirit, mind. And I don't want to get frou-frou here. I just want to be extremely practical because we're.
Now, you're a good singer.
Yeah.
Festering with salt with sores is in some ways one phrase, right?
Yes.
It's not festering with sores. So maybe
It might be.
one sound really
No, it
festering,
might
no.
be. If you took your time, if you took your time and really allowed yourself the space festering
Yep, I understand.
with
I'm going to
sores.
try. I'm going to try now, unless you
Why
want
not?
to try. Okay. Festering with sores. Oh, and you've helped teach me I can enjoy the sounds of that.
That's right.
Festering. Leave out. Let's just do festering, or do
That's right.
just do sores. That's easier. That's only one. Sores.
Wow. That's all that's necessary,
Right.
boy.
Sores. Oh my. So it's allowing the sounds and the words.
Yes.
Sing through, it's almost feeling like they dance my body
Exactly.
if I dare, if I really dare. So if I say festering, let's see. Oh, you see what I just said it with my head. If I say festering, I've left you. Let me try again. I should try even that phrase. If I say festering, that festers me. It brings up my festering without, as you would say, trying.
Without trying.
If I can bear it. Festering with sores.
Wow.
Will rot many cores.
Many what?
Sorry, many cores.
Many cores.
Cores.
Stay with your long sores, cores. Get off your K and really say your K. Try it. Cores.
Cores. No?
Cores.
Cores. No?
There it is. There it is. The K is lovely. And then let the O be as in sores, cores.
Now we only have 2.5 minutes.
Oh.
Next time, 2 weeks. I'd love to explore feelings before I speak. Could I feel festering in some degree? If I would say to you, Susan, I'm sore all over, I would be feeling the sore before I say the sound sore, right? Susan, I'm.
Your nervous system already has it intact. You don't have to work so hard. Your
Right,
nervous system,
but I have
yes.
to be honest with I used to, it was so painful, I would just describe it with my head. But I need, would love you to say goodbye to our audience.
We have about 90 seconds. It's too soon to say goodbye. We just started. Michael, thank you so much. It's been a joy to be here with your rotting to the core with you and your festering sores. I thank you for having me on. Aha, aha, aha. I really appreciate it, Michael. Thank you.
So we'll see you all 2 Thursdays from now.
Yeah.
5 o'clock to find out how to unknot when we've got rot.
Okay. Thank you so much. And to everybody out there, thank you.
And much healing love to and through you, Susan, and all of us at CCTV. And all of us.
Oh, yes. Thank God for CCTV. You.
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 You. You is the sound, the primal sound like Om, that sings us all into being.
You.